Hello students, welcome back to another section of data communication and computer network. In this section we will learn about modem, that is a device which normally having modulation and demodulation. In computer network there are different types of switching devices. Those are used for communicating data between two points, that is transmitter end to receiver end. First of all, the hardware devices that are used to connect computers, printers or other peripherals and other electronic devices to a network are called network device. Basically, you know that a network is consisting of three subsequents, particularly like sections or three subsequents elements, basically sender, receiver and medium. So there are certain networking devices there. Those are directly related with the network. These devices transfer data in a fast, secure and correct way over some or different networks. So according to the requirement of the network, there are certain elements, those are interrelated with the network. So there are certain mediums also there, or there are certain devices also there which are normally or widely implemented for transferring of data in a fast as well as secure and correct way from point to point. Network devices may be internetwork or intranetwork. So according to the requirement of the network or the geographical structure of the subsequent network or the area, we are normally implementing the devices. Either it may be related with internal network or it may be external network. Some devices are installed on the devices like NIC, that is network interface card, whereas some are the part of the network like routers, switches, bridges, gateways, etc. On the previous sections, we would learn about the different network devices such as routers, bridges, switches, gateways, NIC, so on. So the particular network is must require these types of devices which are installed or to create a network interface. Generally, a modem is normally consisting of two things, MOD, DEM, that is MOD stands for modulation and DEM stands for demodulation. So modems are used for data transfer from one computer network to another computer network through telephone lines. So as you know that there are basically three elements there, or there are three basic elements which are normally create a single network, that is sender, medium and as well as receiver, that is transmitting and receiving end, and the data can be transmitted from the transmitter end to receive on the receiver end through a particular medium. So modems are basically called the data transfer device or the data transfer machine from one computer network to another computer network over a telephone line. The computer network works in a digital mode. So generally computer network works in a digital particularly mode, while analog technology is used for carrying messages across the phone lines. So there are certain things there are in a network. There are sender or receiver are the computers, which are normally handle the digital mode of data or information, and the cable or the wire or the medium, either it may be like physical or it may be logical, that is actually without cable or with cable, that particular cables are carrying the analog messages or the analog signals or the analog technology while communicating with one system to another system. Modem is a device that enables a computer to send or receive data over a telephone or cable lines. Let us say earlier, basically modem is a networking device or network device which is widely implemented for sending and receiving data over a telephone line or a cable line from transmitter end to receiver end. The data stored on the computer is digital because it is in a file form or it is in an application form, whereas the telephone lines or cable can transmit only analog signals. So basically, on the previous section we learn about analog and digital signals. So the computer always based on the digital mode, and the medium which are widely implemented for communicating like two end systems, either it may be a terminal to another terminal, the source and destination, completely based on the analog data. The main function of the modem is to convert digital signal into analog and vice versa, because modem having two subsequents, particularly like devices, or it is a combination of devices, it is known as modulator and demodulator. So the modulator may a modulator can used for converting the digital signal into analog signal, and the demodulator widely implemented for converting the analog signal to the digital signal itself. So first of all, the modulator converts the digital data into analog data when the data is being sent by the computer from the transmitting end. And on the other side, the demodulator converts analog data signal into digital data when it is being received by the computer, that is normally called the receiving end systems. So generally, a particularly network device that is called modem is based on two subsequent particularly methods or two subsequent particularly techniques. One thing is called modulation, or that is the modulator, and the second one is called demodulation. It is being widely implemented by the help of the device called demodulator. Basically, a modulator and demodulator widely implemented for converting the digital signal to analog signal and analog signal to digital signal. Come to the next part. That is modulation and demodulation. So modulation is nothing. At the very first, it receives data from the computer in the digital format, that is in the file form or any other particularly digital form. Then the modem converts it to analog format to send it over the telephone line, that is the medium. And this particular process is called modulation. So first of all, the modulation part, MOD or modulation part, is basically related with the computer, that is DTE, that is the terminal, which is normally having the digital format, and the modem, that is DCE, is basically converts the digital signal into the analog form, and after that it can send the subsequent particular analog form over the telephone line or the medium which is related or connected with that. And the second one is called demodulation. Demodulation is called the vice versa of the modulation technique or modulation. In this particular demodulation, the data goes to the other receiving end, that is the receiver, in analog format, or it is normally in the analog form while traveling in the telephone line. The modem on the other side of the receiver end, it converts it to the digital format in order to the computer system understanding. Basically, there are two end systems, that is one DTE in one end and other DTE in another end, that is the transmitter and receiver. In between, there are two subsequent particular sections there, that is modulator and demodulator. So first of all, the source computer will send certain information to the destination system, that is, you can say the receiver. And first of all, the digital form should be converting into the analog form, and this particularly format or this particular technique is called modulation. And the analog signal which normally travels in the or which normally follows or carries the telephone line or the medium, again it reconverting into the digital form, which can be easily understood by or receiving by the receiver end. So this is the particularly diagram for communicating. So there are two sections there, that is A and B. So this is the A, it is called the source of the transmitter, and this is called B. B is normally called the receiver end. So first of all, the computer A wants to send data to the B point over a particular telephone line or cable. At the very first, computer A normally sends the digital data to its nearby, that is a modem, and modem can receive the digital signal and converts it into the analog form. And after that, the modem connect with the point B, that is the other side of the particularly modem, and the analog signal is normally converted into the digital form, and which can be received by the point B itself. And this particular things normally known as modulation and demodulation. So basically, this is the standard format. When an analog facility is used for data connection or communication between two devices called DTE, that is data terminal equipment, modems are widely implemented or widely used at each end. So the DTE can be a terminal of a terminal or a computer in this particular diagram. So there are basically computer A, and which normally sends the digital signal to its nearby modem or to the interrelated modem, and the modem is directly connected with the telephone line to the other modem which is related or which is linked with the like computer B. And in this, in between, the telephone lines are normally connecting with the first modem or the transmitter modem, and followed by the receiver modem. So these are the two subsequent network. This is network A and this is network B. So by the help of the telephone line, the signal which is normally travels, that is called the analog signal or the analog form of the data, because the transmitter modem can particularly convert the digital signal into analog signal, and the other end modems or the, you can say, the receiving end modems which normally receive the analog signal, and again it reconverting it into the digital signal, and after that the point B or the computer B then receive that signal in the form of digital. And basically the modem at the transmitting end converts the digital signal generated by the DTE, as I say, into the analog signal, and so on so forth. So this is the basic, you can say, the standard building block of the modem. So first of all, this is the modem, and it having two subsequent particular devices, modulator and demodulator, that is transmitter and receiver, and this is the two-way communication. So first of all, DTE can connect with its digital particular interface, that is the digital form of data, and after that, that particular digital convert a digital particular interface can convert it into, like by the help of the modulator, and after that by the help of the line interface, that is called the telephone line and so on so thing. It may be a transmission medium or it may be a telephone instrument, like you can say phone or certain things are normally implemented. And in the vice versa mode, the particularly like line interface again reconverting into the subsequent particularly digital signal into analog and analog into the digital form. And basically, so this is the simple diagram where there are certain particular handshaking concepts are there. What is handshaking? So generally this is basically called a diagram. So it having, there are certain points, that is DTE, that is like you can say the terminal, and followed by RTE, then followed by the CTS and DC. These are the certain terms. Just I could explain this type of things. Like first of all, DTE is nothing. The data terminal equipment, this is data terminal equipment, and this is called RTE or RTS. It is basically ready to send the information from the terminal or we can say the DTE, and after that it can connect it with the DCE. And as you know that DCE is nothing, it is called the data communication equipment, and followed by the particular things can be, this is the basically data, and the DCD. DCD stands for data carrier, particularly DTEC. And after that, on the other end, it also having DDR, and the DDR stands for data terminal ready, and followed by DCR, and DCR stands for data set ready. So just take a particular thing. To begin with, the data terminal equipment, that is DT, better known as a computer, sends a ready to send or RTS, that is RTS stands for ready to send signal to the data communication equipment or DCE. It is better known as the modem. So first of all, the terminal should send its particularly message or the digital particularly form of data to the RTS, that is normally called the RTS signal, ready to send signal, to the DCE, that is the data communication equipment, or to the modem. And this particularly sometimes known as a backup call, and as well as result in the modem sending a data period delay or DCD signal to the receiving modem. So normally in the previous part we learn about, so there are basically there are two end systems, there are two DDEs there, in between there are two DCE there, that is one particular DC related, or DC in this case DC is normally called as modem. One modem is related with or connecting with the transmitting end, another modem normally connecting or linked with the receiving end, or that is called the receiver end. So particularly the data which is passed from the DDE, that is called ready to send signal, to the subsequent particularly modem, that is DCE, and after that DCE can communicate with the sending that particularly modem, that is basically called data carrier decoder or DCD signal to receiving modem. So in between there are a particular telephone communication there. There particularly then follows a series of signal passed between the two until the communication channel has been established. Means when you send a particularly signal from or the request from the transmitting end or the receiving end, so there are a certain communication modes there, or there are certain particularly like communication contains there which can be established in between the subsequent end systems, that is system one with the system two, and this particular process is basically called handshaking process. After all that particular means, after establishing all the subsequent thing, the second modem that is related or that is linked with the receiving particular end to send a data set ready, that is DSR, it is ready for the data set to its computer, because the analog signal, or you can say the digital signal, is converting into analog signal by the first modem, and after that the analog signal travels or you can say transmit over a telephone line, and after that the receiving particularly modem can receive the analog signal and converting into the digital one, and that particular digital conversion signal is ready to, or it is normally called basically the DSR signal. Then particularly when that this particular things happen, the first modem send to send or CTS signal to the computer that starts the that started the whole process of, and particularly data can be transmitted. It is in a simple as that. It means first of all a particularly link should be created in between the transmitter modem and as well as the receiving modem, and to which first of all it can be established, and over the medium it can actually convert the digital signal into analog form by the first modem or the transmitter modem, and after that the receiving or the receiver modem can convert the signal or incoming signal, that is analog signal, into its digital conversion, and it can be easily understood by the particularly second one. And this is the basic diagram. In between the data is there, and followed by the DTE, and followed by the second DTE can communicate. It is normally DTE basically ready, or that is called the ready to send message or ready to send signal to the DCE. DCE stands for data communication equipment, that is basically known as like you can say the modem, and after that it can by the help of DCE. DCD is nothing, it is called the data carrier particularly device or data carrier particularly like detect the particularly the data can be traveled here to the subsequence like the receiving modem, that is DCE, and after that the by the help, that is the DSR stands for data set ready, to the subsequence thing. So in between there are two subsequent things there, that is CTS and as well as DDR. And next to the particularly in this section, next particular point is the types of modems. So basically modems can be several types and they can categorize into number of ways. In general there are two types of modems there. One thing is called internal, another thing is called external modem. So according to the internal and external modem, it can be categorized into three basic types or three basic modems are there. So categorization is usually based on the following basis modem features, because every individual particular devices having its own features. The first one is called directional capacity. As you know that there are certain particularly modes, there are communication transmission modes there, like simplex, half duplex and full duplex mode. The first particularly category normally belongs to the directional capacity, that is half duplex modem or full duplex modem. And the second particular feature is connection to the line. So the connection between the subsequence, particularly like source or transmitter and as well as the receiver. So it having two subsequence things like 2-wire modem and 4-wire modem. As you know that half duplex having two particularly wire which is directly connecting with its subsequence end, and 4-wire modem is normally related with the full duplex mode. And the third one is basically called the transmission mode. In the previous section, we learn about the synchronization or asynchronous mode, particularly things or transmission. So the third particular thing is called transmission mode. It normally containing asynchronous and synchronization mode.